Hello everyone. In this video, I'll be giving you a short introduction to Azure. My name is Nandita Gaur. I am a student of ABS Engineering College. Currently, I'm in final year pursuing BTech from Computer Science and Engineering branch. Right now, I'm a Gold Microsoft Learn Student Ambassador. You can connect with me on the following links. So let's get started. Firstly, I'll tell you a brief introduction. Then I'll tell you what is cloud computing. Then what is Azure? After that, I'll be giving you a tour of Azure services. Then I'll tell you how to create Azure accounts. Talking of prerequisites, I'm just assuming that you have a little knowledge of basic computing concepts and you have a little understanding of clouds and its terminologies. But don't worry if you don't have these knowledge, because I'll be telling you everything in short. So let's start with the introduction. What is Azure? Azure is a cloud computing platform giving us a lot of services. And these range of services start from web hosting, and it can be extended towards virtual computer-based customized solutions. Yes, all over the world, businesses are using Azure for their solutions. We can also use Azure for remote storage, for the database hosting, for centralized account management. But now Azure is also offering artificial intelligence and Internet of Things based services. So isn't that interesting? So let us dive deep into the details. What is cloud computing? Have you ever wondered what is cloud computing? Actually, it is a delivery of computing services over the internet, and that part is known as the cloud. And what kind of services these are? These are hosting servers, providing you storage, databases, networking, software, analytics, intelligence, and whatnot. In short, if I tell you, the categories of the services are divided into three parts. IaaS, it stands for infrastructure as a service. Here, Azure is providing you an infrastructure so that you can host your servers. You can use the infrastructure provided by the Azure, and it is also handled by the Azure. Also, you can use platform as a service. By platform as a service, I mean that you can use Microsoft Azure to host your software, your application, whatever your business want to do that. And if I talk about SaaS, it stands for software as a service. You can also use Microsoft Azure as software as a service. It provides you a wide variety of free services, totally free. For example, let me, you might have listened about Microsoft 365, your Office 365. This is a kind of software as a service provided by the Microsoft. And you know why cloud computing is better than other type of services? Because it supports pay-as-you-go pricing model. What does that mean? Suppose if your business is taking on rent some of the services, like they are buying extra storage, they are buying extra servers, then you might have to pay for your machines even when they are not in use. But cloud computing offers you the flexibility. You only pay when you are using the resources of some other company. Also, cloud computing provides you easy scaling. Like if you are using your machines only two times a day, then you pay for only two times a day. If you are using your machines five times a day, then you pay for the five times a day. Also, suppose if you know that in winters or some particular season, your business needs some small machines. So you can buy those small machines. And suppose in the summer season, your servers are very much busy. You might need a lot of servers. So then the cloud computing provides you the easy scaling feature, like scale down or scale up according to your business needs. Also, cloud provides you a high availability of your services all the time. It is being guaranteed by Microsoft Azure that your services won't be ever down. 99.999% Microsoft Azure guarantees that your services will be always available. And one of the biggest advantages of cloud computing is that it provides you the disaster recovery. For suppose if you are storing everything of your business like in a room or some place or some physical servers, then it is a very fair chance that some disaster might hit your room and a lot of important data is lost. But cloud computing provides you the flexibility over that. It provides you a great disaster recovery schemes because the every data is not stored on a single location. It is distributed all over the geographical world. Like your server might be present in India, next server might be present in Australia, another might be in Africa or whatnot. So your data is very much in the secure hands. So this is the cloud computing. And what is Azure? Azure, it is a continuously expanding set of cloud services, which is built totally on your terms. It is a kind of hybrid cloud. What is a hybrid cloud? That is neither a public nor a private cloud. You can choose Microsoft Azure to do whatever you want. For example, if you want to select it for using infrastructure as a service, you can do that. If you are using it as a software as a service, you can do that. So all over the business around the world are using Azure in one way or the other. And you know why should we trust Azure? Because it is having a very high security. It is hosted by Microsoft, which is a very trusted firm. So Azure is providing a very secure system to you and your business. And it provides 100 plus services, ranging from virtual machines to the mixed reality, to the artificial intelligence. Everything you can do on Azure. You can use their frameworks, their services, a lot more of things. So let me tell you in detail, what does Azure provides to you? Now I'm going to give you a tour of Azure portal and Azure marketplace. So let's get started. Let me share my screen. Yeah, so let me share my screen very really fast. Azure portal, it's you go to portal. Portal.azure. Yeah, so this is a Microsoft Azure portal. Firstly, you need to log in into that, and I have applied the automatic logging. Yeah, so this is the Microsoft Azure portal. Here you can find all of the services provided by Microsoft Azure to you. This is a totally customizable dashboard. You can customize it in any way you want. This is the notification hub wherein you get all your subscription details and everything. Here you can check what is your account. You can also switch your accounts as you want. And this is the dashboard. You have a cost management facilities. You have Azure Monitor. You have Security Center and whatnot. So here from that, you can create a resource like anything you want. So this is the Azure marketplace. Let me tell you more into detail. What kind of market is it is providing? Yeah, so see what a great range of services the Microsoft Azure is providing to you. It provides you everything related to AI and machine learning. And who provides these facilities? Actually, these facilities are provided by Microsoft or the trusted firms. Like you can see that there are services by Microsoft, there are services by Datonomous and DefineCrowd and etc. So these are the partner companies of Microsoft and some services provided totally by Microsoft. And we have a lot good range of services. Like let's look into what's in analytics. Yeah, so see here is also it provides you a Power BI, Data Factory, and Classify 360, and whatnot. So these are the kind of services that Azure provides, like blockchain, compute. From compute, you can create virtual machines. You can create containers like Docker and Kubernetes. You can also create databases, blob storage or queue storage, and many more things. It provides you also some developer tools. You can also dive into DevOps and see the list is quite large. There's a mixed reality portal, there's networking, there is security. So in short, whatever your business needs, Azure provides you definitely. Let me share the presentation again. As you have seen, Azure is really a nice portal. Like you can do anything you want, literally anything. All of the organization meetings are handled by Azure in a very effective manner, and you have a lot of services that you can take leverage of, and a lot of things. So I have provided you a little tour of what is Azure and what is the Azure Marketplace. So basically, these are the kind of services provided by Azure Microsoft. So these are the compute, the storage services, the database services. You have also IoT hubs, the AI. You can also manage your artificial intelligence related tasks. Like you can create your chatbots, and you can also do networking related stuff and mobile developments, web development. You can do web hosting. You can create frameworks, and you can also leverage big data and DevOps and whatnot. So this is the kind of all the services provided to you by the Azure. So isn't that interesting? See the security and management, the integration tasks, the application and platform development, the data development, intelligent, whatnot. So I suggest you to take screenshot of that and explore everything the Azure provides to you. Yeah, so thank you. That's all from me. And before I quit, let me tell you how to create the Microsoft account. Let me tell you some advantages of your free Microsoft account. Yeah, so you at this, so to create a Microsoft Azure account, you should go to azure.microsoft.com. Yeah. So as soon as you land on this page, you'll see startup for free. You can create a free Microsoft Azure account. Like you don't need to pay anything for creating a free account. And what's in view for free account? You have 12 months of popular free cloud services like AI, compute, storage, network, and databases. So, and if you're a student, you have $100 per month credit. And if you are a Microsoft Learn Student Ambassador, you have $150 credit every month so that you can take leverage of these services. And 25 services are always free, which include the cost management, your Azure Monitor. And for 30 days, you have $200 credit. So I suggest you making a Microsoft Azure account right now. So, yeah, that's all. That's all from me. Thank you so much for listening to this video. Thank you.
Thank you.